Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called, Please Bring My Coat. The memory verse is from Hebrews chapter 6, verse 10. It says, God will not forget your work and the love you have shown him as you have helped his people and continue to help them. Today's message is when we help people who serve God, we serve God too. Have you ever traveled a long way from home? Have you ever gone to visit relatives? Have you ever been to camp? How did it feel to sleep in a new place? Did you get a letter or a package while you were there? How would getting a letter from home make you feel? Paul knew what it was like to be far away from home and friends. Four stone walls surrounded him. Up toward the ceiling, a small window tried to light the darkness in that prison cell. The cold stone floor he was sitting on seemed to be part of his body. His ankles were chained to the floor as though he was a dangerous animal. But he was not dangerous. He was Paul, a servant of God. Early in his life, Paul had cruelly treated people who believed Jesus was God's son. He had even ordered some to be put to death by stoning. But God had changed his life, and Paul became one of the strongest defenders of Jesus Christ. At this time, the Roman Emperor Nero was against Christians. Many Christians had been put to death because they worshiped Jesus. Paul was certain that he would be put to death too. Paul was thinking about his young friend Timothy. Timothy had become like a son to him. The young man had cried the last time they said goodbye. From the time he was a child, Timothy had been taught about Jesus. His family had invited Paul into their home many times. Now a young man, Timothy often traveled with Paul. Together they had preached and encouraged other Christians. Paul had been thrown into prison several times for preaching the good news, but he had a feeling that he wouldn't survive this time. He was older. The weather was turning colder and colder as winter approached. And if the cold weather didn't kill him, the emperor probably would. Paul took up a sheet of parchment and a pen. Thoughtfully, he began his last letter to Timothy. To Timothy, my dear son, he began, I constantly remember you in my prayers. Recalling your tears, I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. He reminded Timothy that Jesus had destroyed death. That was the good news everyone needed to hear so they could be joyful. Paul was not ashamed to suffer for sharing the good news with others. It was such good news, and he was eager to tell everyone. However, Paul was lonely. It seemed that everyone in Asia had deserted him. No one had come to his defense when he was on trial. The few people had encouraged him meant so much to him. Paul listed the name of one friend who had searched throughout Rome to find and visit him in prison. He asked Timothy to deliver his greetings to several others who had served him and cared for his personal needs. And finally, he asked Timothy to come and visit him before winter and bring him his coat. It was cold in the stone prison. Pastors also feel lonely sometimes. They spend most of their time thinking about the needs of others. Wouldn't it be a wonderful surprise if you planned a way to help your pastor? It doesn't take much to be of service. A smile, flowers after church, even a drink of water will bring your pastor joy. And it will make you feel good too. Why not try it?
This podcast is read by Franita Buddy for Gracelink.net. Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. Post-produced by Faith Toe at Studio El Piso. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. Animation and artwork by Giogo Godoy. The audio engineer was Karel Holness. For more information, please visit gracelink.net.